Hello, Boys and Braves, and welcome to KBHS TV.
Today is Friday, September 6th. I'm Parker Kading.
And I'm Noah Young, and these are your first weekly video announcements of this school year.
We are excited to broadcast to you from our new Mac Lab on campus, which is located upstairs in the Performing Arts Building.
And while we are at it, we want to mention a sincere thanks to the Boise Brave boosters and all who voted in favor of passing a bond a few years ago. This new space would not be possible without you.
Speaking of making something possible, did you hear about the work Ms. Schanfeld's art classes did with the Memory Project?
Sure didn't, but I bet you can enlighten me.
Here's a look at the impact they made. Roll it.
Toga, our first dance of the school year, was a couple of weeks ago and sadly got shut down early.
With homecoming on the horizon, it is important to understand how we can ensure future dances don't end the same way.
Please listen to this short message from the student leadership about ways we can improve for upcoming dances. Take a look.
Hello, Boise High. We have a couple of important announcements to make regarding the school dances that may happen in the future. I'd like to start by explaining why Toga was ended early. There were a lot more factors that weighed into Mr. Thompson's decision than just crowd surfing. Whether you realize it or not, some students were injured during the dance. As a senior this year, I was super disappointed to see that the reason my last toga ever at Boise High was ended early is because of the dangerous behavior of the underclassmen. There is a lot of planning and effort that goes into every dance at this school. School staff give up their Friday nights. This class took time out of their summer, and it kills me to see that some of you carelessly threw it down the drain. Going into homecoming, the attendance of some people will be questioned if the behavior continues. The teachers and staff didn't want the dances to end the way it did, but the environment was genuinely unsafe for the dance to continue. Thank you for your time, and let's focus on making the next dance for Boise High way more fun for everybody.
It's time for today's club and event news. Gabriel, tell us what's happening.
I'm Gabriel Phillips, and it's time for your club and activity report. Usually, my job is to tell you about the amazing clubs we have on campus. However, why should I do something that you can do yourself? That's right, my friends. I empower you to seek out the great opportunities from an array of amazing choices. If you aren't picking up what I'm dropping right now, let me simplify it for you. Club Rush is happening today at lunch in the quad. You don't want to miss this great opportunity to see all Boise High has to offer. Well, this has been Gabriel. You are officially up to date. Back to you, Noah.
Let's turn things over to Ontario at our sports desk. Ontario, tell us the score.
Hi, Brave fans. I'm Ontario Persley, and it's time to talk about sports. Our fall athletes have been working hard, and it's time to get outside and cheer them on to victory. Good luck to our cross-country runners who are traveling to Idaho Falls today to compete in a meet. Both the boys and girls squads are off to a great start thus far in this season. More good luck to our football team, who travels to collide with Centennial tonight at 7 p.m. Please consider coming out to root on the Brave. Well, that's your sports wrap. This has been Ontario reporting. Now back to you, Noah.
And now it is time for today's words of wisdom. As we finish our third week of school, it is important to remember each of us have a fresh start for the year. Buddha once said, there are only two mistakes one can make along the road to truth. Not going all the way and not starting. Remember, you can make it a great day or not. The choice is yours. This has been Noah.
And I'm Parker, sharing what's up.
Thanks for watching, Boise High.